including your kids. You leave it there, I'll get on next ride around. Please wear your mask, guys. That's mandatory in Orange County, which we're in Orange County. Appreciate that. Here we go. Skating lands been around for a very long time, since 1949. The late O. Wayne Goblin started the park, but he did not name a gator land. He named it the Florida Fish and Wildlife Institute. Shortly after that, he said, well, that sounds kind of boring. So he renamed his park Snake Village. Now, not too long after naming the park Snake Village, Owen realized a lot of people were afraid of snakes and definitely didn't want to come to a park full of them. So he decided to rename his park Gatorland. Now we're always expanding at Gatorland over to the right. Stomping Gator Off-Road Adventure. Make sure you go check out that big old swamp buggy in that back lot of Gatorland. To the right, Jungle Croc's location starts off with Pops, our oldest American alligator. He's around 80 years old. Yeah, Cuban crocodiles has a small breeder crocodile, but a very feisty one. Starting off to the right, closest to the train is saltwater crocodiles, Morton and Sheila. In the middle, you have Big Daddy Dundee and Phoebe. And last but not least, you have Salty Girl hanging out. She's over by the rocks. Saltwater crocodile is native to Southeast Asia and Australia. Has a very large breed of crocodile reaching over 15 feet and over 2,000 pounds. And right there, you can see Blondie, one of our Nile crocodiles. We have three Nile crocodiles. Nile crocodiles native to Africa. You see those guys jumping out of the water for wildebeest or zebra. We're entering the Piney Woods, very large natural time enclosure we have for a few of our animals here. Over to the right, you see our Zebu. Those are miniature cattle from India with Tay. Tay's a European fallow deer, but she thinks she's a Zebu, so she hangs out with those guys all day. If you look throughout the enclosure, guys, you'll see our white-tailed deer hanging out. White-tailed deer are native to North America. See our peacock Lenny over to the right too. That is a male peacock. They have the long feathers. It is mating season for them, so they'll open up those feathers, shake them around like a little dance. Now to the left, you'll see the second largest flightless bird in the world. That is the Australian emu. When they lack and fight, they make it for a land speed. They can run about 35 miles an hour. Folks, we're gonna head on back to the train station. If you want to walk over this way, you got pearls if you want to get a bite to eat. You have the swamp walk, the white alligators, as well as the Legends of the Swamp show. the Legends of the Swamp show starting in about 1 minute. As you can say that, we got a few more of those shows today. Over to the left, back of the Bobcat Bayou, we have 3 Bobcats, 2 males, 1 female. We also have a very cool African servo cat in there as well. Over to the left, up close encounter show. You can go get up close and personal with a few of our creepy crawlies. So back in the petting zoo, you can pet the goats, you can feed the goats, you can talk to the goats. Sometimes they talk back. You can also go see our capybara. That's the largest rodent in the world, but ours are babies. Go check them out. To the right, start of our 10-acre breed ranch, about 130 alligators in there, 100 females, 30 very lucky males. Now, if you want to see this year's babies from the breeding marsh, head on over to the baby marsh. It's right by the Florida Panthers and the Pythons. Splash pad over here if you want to cool off. Now, as we are coming back into the train station, please stay seated, guys. We're going to exit from the front of the train to the back of the train, keeping that social distancing. Just stay seated until it's safe to exit. I'm going to go ahead and hop out and grab that chain for you guys. Thank y'all.